Today, we have brought you another exciting documentary on a field marshal of India. Till date, India has two field marshals. Once upon a time, a field marshal had said, "If anyone tells you he is never afraid, he is a liar or a Gorkha." It was famously said by Sam Bahadur. Today, we are going to talk about Field Marshal of India, Sam Manekshaw. Sam Manekshaw, also known as Sam Bahadur, was born in Amritsar, Punjab, on 3rd April 1914. Born to Hilani Mehta and father Hormazid Manekshaw. Sam Manekshaw had 5 siblings. A field marshal is the highest position above the chief of the army staff in the Indian Army. Manekshaw did his primary study in Punjab and later he went to Sherwood College in Nainital. In 1929, at the age of 15, he went to the University of Cambridge. In 1931, he passed the University of Cambridge with distinction. Sam Manekshaw wanted to study in the fields of medicine, but his father refused, flatly stating that he was already supporting his 2 elder brothers' study and he was not old enough to travel to London. Hence, Manekshaw entered the Hindu College Amritsar and passed with 3rd division in science. The same year, at the Indian Military Academy was established. Manekshaw then joined the Indian Military Academy as the first batch. On the 1st of October 1932, he was selected out of the many cadets. On 1st February 1935, he graduated into the army as a second lieutenant. After joining into the army, Manekshaw did not get promotion due to a shortage of qualified officers. And then the 1942 Burma War had broken out. He was appointed as a temporary captain or major. On the 4th of February 1942, he was promoted to a major. He was then posted in Burma in the 1942 campaign near Sitang River. Due to his bravery, he was awarded the Military Cross by the British government. After India and Pakistan's independence in 1947, Manekshaw's unit was a part of the Pakistan Army. But Manekshaw was shifted to the Indian Army and assigned as a part of the 8 Gorkha Rifles. After independence, Manekshaw handled issues related to the 1947 Indo-Pak War and was the commanding officer of the 5th Gorkha Rifles. On 1st March 1959, he was promoted to the rank of Major General. Thereafter, on the 1st October 1959, he was appointed as the Commandant of the Defence Service College, Wellington. At that point, he was caught up in a case which would end his career. In May 1961, General Thimya resigned as the Chief of the Army Staff. Hence, General Pranath Thapar took over the office. Then Defence Minister Mr. Menon promoted Brijmohan Kaul to the position of Lieutenant General and heir to the office of the Chief of Army Staff. General Thamya did not like it and resigned. On his resignation, succession followed, in which Major General Pranath Thapar took over the command as the Chief of the Army Staff, while Kaul took over the position of Lieutenant General. This was made by disapproval by many senior officers, including Manekshaw. Lieutenant General Kaul sent spy over Manekshaw, as he had also disapproved Kaul's promotion. Kaul gathered information and made a court inquiry against him. Meanwhile, the Indochina War broke out, and Manekshaw could not participate. And when asked by Nehru, then Prime Minister of India, Manekshaw told it was a conspiracy made against him to ruin his career. On the 28th of July 1963, he was made a Lieutenant General. In 1964, the following year, he was made the General Officer of the Eastern Command of the Army. In response to an insurgency in Nagaland, he acted quickly and bravely. Due to his bravery and administration skills, he was then awarded the Padma Bhushan. On 8th of June 1969, Manekshaw was appointed as the 8th Chief of Army Staff. In his tenure, he led the army to the Indo-Pak War of 1971 and brought various changes and developed the army into an efficient war of instrument. At the end of the 1970s, Pakistan Army launched various attacks, due to which many East Pakistanis fled to India and settled in West Bengal. It was the tenure of then Prime Minister of India, Indira Gandhi. In April of 1971, a cabinet meeting was held to decide to assist Bangladesh on its freedom. Prime Minister Indira Gandhi asked Manekshaw if he was ready to launch a war with Pakistan. He refused, telling his troops were at various places. At the end of the cabinet meeting, he offered to resign his job, but the Prime Minister declined and sought Manekshaw's advice. He said that victory would be there if she allowed him to handle the whole matter. Following this, he trained and equipped the Bangladesh Army and the Indian Army. The war officially started on the 3rd of December 1971. Under Sam Manekshaw's leadership, the whole plan was chalked out and executed. As war progressed, Pakistan's resistance crumbled. Sam Manekshaw addressed the Pakistan Army on radio on 9th, 11th and 15th December to surrender. On the 15th of December, General Niazi of Pakistan decided to surrender to the Indian Army. The message was conveyed via UN Security Council to Sam Manekshaw. He stated that he would only stop the war if Pakistan surrendered to all Indian counterparts by 9 in the morning of 16 December. Later on, the time was extended by 3 p.m. in the afternoon. On the same day, on Niazi's request, the instrument of surrender was signed at Dhaka. When the Prime Minister Indira Gandhi asked Sam Manekshaw to go and surrender, he replied that it would be an honor if the General Officer of the Eastern Command, Lieutenant General Jagjit Singh Ora, would sign it. He saw that all the prisoners of war were treated respectfully and all amenities were made available. Also, there would be a complete peaceful handover of the prisoners of war to Pakistan. After war, Indira Gandhi decided to honor Manekshaw with the rank of Field Marshal of India, and his tenure was extended by 6 months from the June of 1972. In recognition of his outstanding service, he was also awarded the Padma Vibhushan in a formal ceremony on the 1st of January 1973. Manekshaw was made a Field Marshal at the Rashtrapati Bhavan, New Delhi, by then President of India, V.V. Giri. On the 15th of January 1973, after 4 decades of service, he retired and settled down in Kunnur near the Defence Service College, Wellington. He was married to Silu Bore on the 22nd of April in 1939 in Bombay. He has 2 daughters. In 1972, he was made an honorary general of the Nepal Army. And in 1977, he was awarded the Order of Tri Shakti Patta by Nepal government. Manekshaw died at the military hospital in Wellington, Tamil Nadu on the 27th June 2008 at the age of 94. He was buried at the Parsi Cemetery in Ooty, Tamil Nadu. Sam Manekshaw will be remembered forever. On 16 December 2008, then President of India, Srimati Pratibha Patil, released a postage stamp depicting Sam Manekshaw. He will be remembered forever for his exceptional leadership, which he showed in the Indo-Pak War of 1971, and for his outstanding service to the nation for 4 decades. Thank you.
Thank you very much for watching this documentary. Do not forget to subscribe to the channel and like the video. Enjoy the last minute views of the ocean. And goodbye.
Goodbye.